Hello guys, this is Sivesh Roy and you're watching Blueberry 69 Visual Effects. Today we are going to create cinematic trailer in After Effects without any third party plugin. So guys, let's have a look what we are going to create today. You can download the project file from the link in the description below. If you have not subscribed my channel yet, consider subscribing. So guys, without any further ado, let's get started. Open After Effects, create a new composition. I am naming it Cinematic Trailer. Taking 1920x1080, frame rate 29.97 and duration 8 seconds. Now right click, create another new composition, name it Text A. Take same settings, hit OK. Right click on timeline, create new text. I am naming it Cinematic. Make 4 copies of this text layer by pressing Ctrl plus D. Place them like that. Now select top text layer and disable the stroke by clicking here. Do same with the second text layer. Now go to the top text layer, right click, layer style and select gradient overlay. Solo top text layer, expand it, go to the gradient overlay settings, then select edit gradient. Edit gradient like that. Now solo the second text layer, right click, layer style and select gradient overlay. Select edit gradient. Edit gradient like that. Now solo both layer. Select second text layer, press P to open position. Set X position value 966 and Y position value 541. Unsolo both layer. Now solo third text layer. Now go to effect and preset window and search for linear Y effect. Apply it into the third text layer. Then change some settings. Set transition completion 48%. Wipe angle 180 degree, set feather value around 123. Now copy linear wipe effect and paste it into the last text layer. Now change the third text layer color to light orange. Now press P to open position. Set X position value to 971. Now select all text layer and copy it. Now create a new composition. I am naming it Text B. Keep same settings. Now paste the text layer into the text B composition. I am renaming the text to Epic Trailer. Now select both text A and text B composition and place it into the cinematic trailer composition. Now arrange both composition layer like that. Now select both composition layer and pre-compose it. I am naming it Text Comp. Select move all attributes to the new composition. Now make a duplicate of a text comp. Now go to effect and preset window and search for linear wipe. Apply this effect into the both text comp layer. Now search for card wipe effect. Apply this effect into the both composition layer. Now solo the top text comp, go to linear wipe effect and change transition completion to 50%. In card wipe effect, change transition completion to 50%. Go to beginning of the animation, then create a keyframe. Go to 5 seconds and change transition completion to 0%. Select back layer to none. Change row to 10 and column to 30. Set flip axis to random. And flip order from right to left. Set gradient layer to none. Now unsolo top text comp and solo the bottom text comp. Go to linear wipe and change transition completion to 50%, wipe angle to negative 90 degree. In card wipe, set transition completion 50%. Go to 0 frames and create a keyframe. Then go around 5 seconds and change transition completion to 0%. Set back layer to none, rows 10 and column 30. Flip axis random, set gradient layer to none. Now unsolo both layer. Now select both composition layer, right click and pre-compose. I am naming it transition, then hit OK. Now right click, create new solid. Go to effect and preset window and search for fractal noise effect. Apply it into the solid layer. Then change some settings. Select noise type to block. Set contrast 379. Go to transform and set scale to 30. Press Alt and click on evolution to write expression. Write expression time start 2000. Set complexity to. Now solo transition layer. Select it. Select rectangle tool and create a mask like that. Align it to the center. Go to mask 1 properties. Set feather to 110. At 0 seconds, create keyframe on mass expansion. Set value to negative 77. Go to 5 seconds. Change its value to 999. Now make a duplicate of mask 1. Set mask 2 mode to subtract. Select both mask expansion keyframes and place them like that. Select all keyframes and easy ease them. Set transition track mat to Luma inverted mat. Now select both layer and pre-compose them. I am naming it block swipe. Now go to project panel, place the transition comp into the timeline. Now create new solid. Select the ellipse tool, create a mask like that. Create another mask like that. Go to effect and preset window and search for fill effect. Apply it into the solid layer. Change its color to white. Change mask 2 mode to subtract. Now select mask 1, mask expansion. Go to the beginning of the animation, create a keyframe. Set its value to negative 229. go to 5 seconds and change its value to 770. Do same with the mask 2. Select all keyframes and easy is them. Place mask 2 keyframes like that. Now apply the turbulent displace effect to the solid layer. Set amount to 383. Size 18. Now select solid layer and pre-compose it. I am naming it circle transition. Now I am making two copies of circle transition and block swipe comp layer. And three copies of transition comp layer. Arrange comp layer like that. Set the block swipe comp layer mode to screen. Now set the both circle transition comp layer to alpha mat. Now search for fill effect. Apply it into the both block swipe comp layer. Change their color. Also apply fill effect to both circle transition comp layer. Change their color to light gray. Now create a new camera. I am taking 35mm preset. Now make all layer 3D. Create a new null object. Make it 3D. Now parent the camera to null 1. Press P to open position. Go to beginning of the animation. Create a keyframe. Set value to 200. Go to 7 seconds 15 frames and change Z value to negative 357. Select both keyframes and easy is them. Place last keyframe like that. Now select all layers and pre-compose them. I am naming it final comp. Select move all attributes into the new composition. Now import the file. You can download the required file from the link in the description below. Select all files and click on import JPEG sequence. Now place them into the timeline. Now set all JPG sequence layer mode to screen. Set lens flare layer mode to screen. Position the lens flare like that. Place the optical JPG sequence into the top of all layer. Now create a new adjustment layer. Place it above the final comp. Now go to Effect and Preset window and search for Hue Saturation Effect. Apply it to the adjustment layer. Set Master Hue to -206. Now search for Curves. Apply it into the adjustment layer. Change RGB curve like that. Apply another copy of curve to adjustment layer. Adjust curve like that. Now I am changing lens flare opacity by pressing T. Keyframe the opacity like that. Select all keyframes and easy ease them. Now create a new solid. I am taking black color. Select rectangle tool and create a mask like that. Set mask mode to subtract. Let's RAM preview it. So guys, give thumbs up if you like this tutorial, share with your friends, hit the subscribe button, and finally thanks for watching.